In this video, we're going to be doing a consumer unit replacement using this fantastic new board from Lewden. So we've already done a benchtop review video of this consumer unit, so look for the link either in the description or in the eye at the top of the screen here. But we thought that in this video, we'd put the board through its paces and see what it actually looks like during the installation process. So we're going to be taking this existing consumer unit off the wall and replacing it with a new one. Now, the reason that we're doing this is that at some point, this wall that the consumer unit is mounted on is going to be insulated, battened off, and overboarded to change this room into a bit of an extension. And so there's not enough slack on these cables as they're currently installed, going over the top of the truss there into the top of the board. So what we're going to do is we're going to install a new consumer unit, which replaces this existing plastic one with a metal one. And we're going to reroute these cables underneath the truss so that there's plenty of slack for that to be pulled forward when this gets overboarded. You can also see that the cables here have not been very kindly treated. They've not been installed incredibly well. So we'll be tidying those up as well. So the old meter tails come up inside this trunking and I don't think they're going to be long enough. So I'm going to replace those and I'm going to replace them with these flexible meter tails from Doncaster Cables, because that's going to make life a little bit easier. But before I do anything, of course, I'm going to make sure that I've safely isolated before I start stripping out the old tails and the old consumer unit. Okay, so that's the old consumer unit off the wall. You can see here that I've marked up all of the cables with the circuits that they're feeding. Fortunately, I can read my own writing, so that'll be handy for me, even if no one else can. I've started prepping the Lewden consumer unit, and I've taken out the two central knockouts at the top here, because that's where the cables will be dropping into. And if you have a look at the grommet that's provided with the Lewden consumer unit, you can see it's got this square shape for the square shape knockout. But what's just worth noting really is if you look at it on the back, can you see you've got a sort of a not symmetrical kind of bit that goes through the consumer unit at the top here. So you can see you've only got a shallow bit there and a large bit there. So when you pop it into the board, you want to make sure that you actually get that the right way around, like so. And then when you push it home, the back of that won't overhang. Now, those square grommets have been designed around popular trunking sizes, and you also get this smaller size one available as well. Just a top tip here for when it comes to bringing your cables through these, it's a good idea, rather than putting a slit in here with a knife, maybe just get a sharp pencil and then just pop a hole through where you want to bring the cable. And what that's going to do is it's going to allow the grommet to form itself and mold itself around the cable, and that's going to make sure that you maintain the IP rating, particularly on the top face of the board there. So now it's just a matter of getting it on the wall. So I've marked up my pencil points, drilling the holes into the wall there. I'm using brown roll plugs and some 1.5 tens with round headed screws on these to make sure that it holds the flat back panel of the board on the wall really nice and firmly. So we'll get that mounted. Ever so easy to work with, went on first time, no problem. And then bringing in the tails through one of the round knockouts that you'll find on every face of this consumer unit. Now, I'm stripping this in two stages. I've got my linesman's pliers, you might have seen there very briefly, and also my knife. I'll be interested to know how you prefer to strip tails. Do you use croppers or a knife or something else? Let us know in the comments. Okay, so as you can see, I've installed my tails and stripped those to the correct length. And what I'm going to do now is use this handy cable clamp just to hold these in place when they go in. So this is a super helpful bit of kit, actually. It's really pretty cool. Now, it's worth mentioning at this stage that this cable clamp is an additional accessory and is available as an extra from Lewden. So make sure that you add that to your list if you want one to go into your board. Just put myself in a position where I can see what I'm doing and then get that into the terminal and crank it up. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to do this up to a reasonable level of tightness. I'm not going to crank this right up now, because hopefully you might be able to just about see on there, we've got 2.5 Newton meters on there, which is the level of torque that we need to apply to that. So I'm going to get my torque screwdriver on that a little bit later in the video, just to do that up to the right level. Now that's the neutral in, I'll get the line in. There we go. And again, not going to crank it, just going to nip it. There we go. And we'll get that up to 2.5 Newton meters a little bit later. Okay, that's good. So that cable clamp, once that's tightened up, we'll just hold those really firmly in place as well and stop those from popping out under most circumstances. Happy days, nice little feature that, I like that. So I'm just going to start popping the RCBOs in here and just clipping those in to the consumer unit there. So we'll start popping those in now. Normally I like to have all of the devices and loads out while I bring the cables in, and that leaves me lots of space to make off the neutrals and the CPCs. However, because this is a purely RCBO board, so the outgoing circuits are all RCBO fed, I've got the neutral tails to dress in and feed around and stuff. So I'm going to install all of the RCBOs first in this case, and then go and bring all the cables in to connect those up. So just a couple of things that it's worth noting about these rather lovely RCBOs from Lewden. The first thing to note is the size of them. So if I bring in one of their older form RCBOs, you can see there the very, very significant difference in size. So the new ones are a lot smaller than the old ones, which is good because that means there's more space to work in the consumer unit than we would have had before. So that's super handy. Another couple of good points about them, all A types. So these are A type RCBOs, not AC. So that means they're going to cope with up to 6 milliamps of pulse DC current going into these, which is good. That means we're not worried about our household appliances backfeeding DC into the system and then blinding the RCBOs and them not operating when we need them to, which is really good. And another nice little bonus about them as well is that they are double pole, so that's going to disconnect both the line and the neutral out of here as well. This has a number of different advantages. It makes the installation work safer because it means you can safely isolate on a circuit by circuit basis, disconnecting the line and the neutral from the same device. It's really helpful having that neutral disconnected for particularly TT systems where you may have a floating voltage sitting on your neutral that could cause you problems, and also for EV charging circuits where the regulations require that both live conductors are disconnected. It also improves the ease and also the speed of your inspection and testing process because it means that you don't have to disconnect the neutral lead during the insulation resistance test, and the two conductors, the line and the neutral terminals, are right by each other, and that means that that's going to speed up your overall installation and commissioning process. Again, just worth noting, when we come to do our talking up of these terminals towards the end of the video, you can see there the bottom ones are 2.5 newton meters and the top ones are 1.2 newton meters. So those little differences there will be worth taking note of when we start making our final connections into those. So I'm going to get the rest of these popped in, bring the cables in, get them fed in, and then start connecting everything up. Okay, so that's all of the circuits connected now. They're all in there. All of the testing for this video is being done off camera because that's not really what this one's all about. However, we do want to have a quick word about torque settings. So you can see along the bottom here that we've got specific torque settings that have been printed on here by Lewden, which is really good. So these ones along the bottom are set to 2.5 newton meters. And also the surge protection device is also, that one's a slightly different because it's got a range that it can be set between, so it's 2 to 2.5. So I'm going to do that one at 2.5 at the top end. And we've also got, you'll notice at the top, we mentioned this earlier, 1.2 newton meters at the top of the RCBOs instead of 2.5. So it's not just one setting does all. Now what I've done off camera is I've been along and I've just slightly undone all of the terminals using just a normal screwdriver, because if someone had come along and sort of done these up, even myself, just done these up and slightly over tightened them, maybe set them to 3 newton meters without realizing, then it's possible that when I come along and now try and do it to the correct torque setting, the screwdriver is going to click out at 2.5 newton meters, but they're actually too tight. So I like to just slacken the screws off a little bit and then go along and do them up to the right level. So we're going to set this torque screwdriver here to 2.5 newton meters. So we'll just get that set to the right value. So on this one, we go from 2.4 to 2.6. So 2.5 is between the two. And then we're going to put the bit holder in. That's that in. And this is a slotted posi number two screwdriver head. So we're going to use the slotted posi number two bit. Pop that in, lock that, and then we're ready to go. And it's just a matter of going along the line and doing these up to 2.5 newton meters. So there we go. That's all of those being done to the correct level. I'd like to just take this moment to tell you about our CPDs that we produce in association with Lewden. So we've got these RCBOs here. We said earlier they're all type A's, and we've actually produced a CPD on the different types of RCD protection and what you can use them for and what you shouldn't use them for. And that's all freely available, fully certificated, fully accredited, fully approved, but all completely free over on eFIXX.co.uk in the know-how section, as well as on the Academy page of the Lewden website. We're doing an MCB here. We've also done one on the different types of MCB that are available. Again, where you apply them and where you don't, including a little bit of myth busting in there, which is pretty helpful. And we've also done one on surge protection devices as well. So please head over to eFIXX.co.uk, Lewden.com, or click the link below, and you'll be able to complete those CPDs and get yourself a certificate as well. So I'll just do up these last two terminals here, and there we go, that's all good to go. Okay, so I'm not going to bore you by showing you every single connection being done to the correct torque setting, but what I do want to talk about is one really nice feature of this consumer unit, and that's that every single screw head along the buzz bar here, the tops of the MCBs, the RCBOs, the main switch, and the earth bar and the neutral bar all have the same screw head on them, and that's that slotted posi number 2, and that means that you don't have to keep on swapping your screwdriver head in and out of your torque screwdriver. The only ones that aren't that slotted posi number 2 are the ones in the top of the surge protection device, purely based on engineering limitations. Now, I'm super proud of myself at this point because I always forget to put the terminal shields back on. The number of consumer unit and distribution board lids that I've taken off and put back on again, simply because I've forgotten to do that, is innumerable. So I'm glad to have got that done. Again, just a couple of points to sort of appreciate. Surge protection device here, some manufacturers don't require MCB protection, some do. In this case, the MCB has been provided to give some local protection and isolation to the surge protection device, rather than relying on the service head fuse to provide this function. So just make sure that you follow the manufacturer's instructions when you're installing that. And yeah, that's the installation pretty much done. So it's just a matter of popping the lid on, sticking a load of labels on, and we're good to go. So there we go, that's this installation complete. I'm sure you'll agree with me that that is one lovely looking consumer unit, and it's no accident that it looks this good. It's been deliberately designed to have a kind of contemporary feel to it, moving away from the old utilitarian, very functional looking consumer units that have been produced by other manufacturers as well. And you can see that in the details, like the wraparound cover that sits over the lid and gives this clean and unobtrusive finish, and has this lovely kind of sweeping aspect to the front of it that gives it a really aesthetically pleasing look. But that cover doesn't just look good, it's also functional. If you look at it when it's opened up, you can see here that it allows full visibility of the devices, even when you're looking at it almost from above. So that means that if this consumer unit was installed perhaps in an understairs cupboard, then you'd still be able to have good visibility on those protective devices. And just sticking with that cover, if you look on the inside surface of it here, you can see that would be a perfect place to put all of your installation stickers, those ones that are very necessary under BS7671. They could all sit under there, thus maintaining the nice, clean, uncluttered look of the front of the consumer unit. But as always, we want to hear from you. What are your favourite points on this Lewden consumer unit? Is it enough to tempt you away from your regular manufacturer, or is it simply enough evidence that you've made the right choice when you install Lewden products anyway? Please leave your thoughts and questions in the comments below, and as always, thank you very much for watching.